News tonight, does probable cause outweigh privacy? KU is considering a policy it says is designed to curb illegal drinking in campus housing. KMBC 9's Bev Chapman is live with more in Lawrence tonight. Bev?
Larry, the University of Kansas is considering a policy change that would allow housing supervisors to enter a student's room without their permission or without a warrant. Now, this follows two alcohol-related student deaths in the last semester, but some people are concerned.
With 8 resident halls and some 30,000 students, the administration is worried about what's going on behind some closed doors in university-owned housing.
Right now, students are able to tell the resident assistants that you can't come into my room, even if there is a suspicion that there is alcohol or drugs being used.
The new policy would change that, allowing a housing supervisor, after asking a student to open up, to use a passkey to enter the room without permission or a warrant, if they have reason to believe probable cause that something illegal is going on.
I agree with people being able to know what's going on inside of their own building, but I do think that people have their own right to privacy.
I believe that everybody has a right to privacy, and I don't believe in any authority or anybody barging into anybody's private space without permission to enter.
It makes sense, I guess, if you're going to let minors live in the dorms and they're doing something that's against the law, that you should intervene for safety's sake.
A university spokesman says a policy change was already in the works, but the death last semester of 2 KU students prompted them to introduce the proposed change this fall. In May, they changed the way they notify parents of on-campus alcohol violations, and this is a continuation of that thinking.
We want to work with our students on ways that we can make this campus a safe campus and reduce the incidence of excessive alcohol consumption.
In light of the recent deaths, I think parents should be aware of what their kids are doing here.
Back live now, here's what the university is calling probable cause. According to Martin, the odor of marijuana, noise from drinking games, or seeing students carrying alcohol into the dorm or university housing. In addition to dormitories, the school's scholarship hall, Jayhawk Tower apartments, and family housing would all fall under the same policy. Now, the proposal has already received unanimous approval by the Student Housery Advisory Committee, but it would also need approval from the Student Senate. We are live in Lawrence, back to Kansas City and you.
Bev Chapman, thank you very much. A university spokesman says the new policy would probably go into effect early in the fall semester.